No more autographs, please.
Where's Johnson? Did he come through with the new quarter?
Well, it's only two rooms in the back, but it's all you got in the back to do.
Well, if there's anything else, just let me know.
There is one thing, Captain. If you could prevail upon yourself to let Dr. Moon go off the bridge, I would greatly appreciate it.
But Mr. Johnson, he's a dangerous character. He goes around carrying a machine gun.
That was mine. He took it from me.
You tried to inform him?
Damn near made it, too. Let him go, Captain, as a favor to me.
Well, I have to go to talk with him first. He's a very strange sort of clergyman.
You wouldn't say that if you saw him in action.
Well, I guess I'll go down and see him now. If you say he's on the side of more upland, there could be no objection.
Thank you, Captain. Why don't you give us a little informal talk on jail life, no, Mr. Johnson? Why does it call you state life, Mr. Johnson? Is it true that Japan does not dare attack America? Well, as long as you're on board.
Come out, will you? What are you trying to prove?
Aren't you proud of yourself, Mr. Johnson?
You can call me state guys.
Billy, Miss Lucy, I'm living amusingly.
I haven't had as much fun since I was a kid.
Do you call it fun to pose as one of the worst criminals who ever lived?
It's not hurting anyone.
It's hurting my respect for you, Billy.
What about your respect for these damn fools who are making a hero out of
me? I never had any respect for them. But you, Billy, you can stop this if you want to.
All right. I'll get them to lay off the hero movement.
Do you really mean it?
I promise.
Oh, Mr. Johnson, we're waiting for you.
That's all right. Why don't you just go out without me?
Oh, but we can't. You've got to crown this upper berth.
Yeah, but I was just telling Miss Harper.
Ah, Belle, have you seen the moonlight?
No, I haven't.
Well, you should take a look at it. It's most inspiring.
So, I'd see you about your sea lights. Say, can't grant me my chance.
I'm sure she meant no offense.
Take your chair, sir.
Thank you very much, Sarah.
Boy, you can eat your great stuff on deck. I bet you can have a check there.
You know, the first time I understood why people speak so highly of the moonlight.
Before we get back to England and have to separate, I'm afraid I'll be carrying the old torch.
Carry a torch? Have you been hearing that nonsense about the London cause?
No, Evie, that means a physical factor.
Does it? Carry your torch. A picturesque.
You know, Evie, if things work out, would you want to get together?
Get together? You may become engaged, married.
That would be for a beginning.
Oh, this comes as something of a shock to me. I never had pictured you as the one-man type.
Well, neither had I. Until now.
But at least 20 men a year proposed to you. Bankers, movie stars, and big politicians.
And not one of them stirs my pulse. I let them know class and dignity. I have some of them. What?
Seems we have. Seems we've made an error.
What's the idea of these people? This isn't a lynch. It's a terrible one. He's not gonna take care of the service.
Well, which one? The army or the navy?
The religious service.
Oh, me?
It's a bit, Judy. Just follow me.
Hey, if anything goes wrong, I'll be here.
Tell the ship's on course, Doctor. Hey, can anyone open?
We're in your hands, Doctor.
Members of the PTA, the WPA, and the DAR. We are gathered here today to try to reform Snake Eyes Johnson, who stands beside me as a repentant sinner.
Hallelujah!
Hey, that ain't bad.
Just a second, Doctor. What about capital punishment?
Well, that was good enough, my father, and it's good enough for me.
Right!
And look at this poor sinner who stands beside me and war with his